There's just a lot of random.
Just yelling. Everybody just.
Yes. Oh. Have you never been to a soccer game? No. That's literally what they
do. I went to one with him.
Yeah, but nobody was doing that.
Oh.
Really? I don't know. Yeah, nobody
was. Well, no one was doing
Europeans,
that.
No. European teams will do that. They're like.
If you watch Chad Lasso.
They're just yelling random things. Have you never?
Really?
Ted Lasso, we've watched.
Oh, I
they
think
get
of,
loud.
I think of more of like the chants.
They
like,
hold.
Roy Kent. Roy Kent. He's there.
But they hold them. They hold them. They hold the chants.
This is the most annoying start. We're like loud noises.
You want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
We're the worst. We are. And I apologize for all of us on behalf of Sunrise.
Okay. They're trying to stop us already.
Okay. So Winter Carnivals started. You know what's funny? Jason, you've highlighted a lot of that. You're like, what is Klondike Gate? What is King Boreas? What is
the
medallion and the jumpers and the Vulcans?
The Vulcans.
There is a lot of kind of strange history.
Sure.
I don't know. Like, it goes back 138 years. Wow.
Was it 1877 on there? No.
And they've been doing the same traditions for so long, and I don't have. I like. It would be interesting to know the backstory. To be honest.
Yeah, I'm confused by
why. Random things that we did back in like the 1800s, or like.
We're like King Boreas is dated all the way back. Yeah, I have no. And then like here, those are the Vulcans, right?
I guess. So I'm learning with you, Jason. Okay. I don't know why. I never was familiar with this growing up here.
Very St. Paul thing.
So wait, you didn't know it existed?
No, I didn't know much about this at all. I think I've heard of it, but I certainly didn't know anything
didn't
about
partake.
It. And I'm still learning every day.
Didn't they have crashed ice there a while ago?
Oh, that was so fun. But that wasn't part of the Winter Carnival. That was its own thing.
Oh, it was.
That was Red Bull. That was amazing. Yeah. It was so cool. And they left us after the day.
That was so fun.
But no, this is just a huge party in St. Paul.
Not on live television. Shout out to Michelle for doing that live on television.
That was scary. We were watching. We were like,
holding our breath.
Live TV. That was must-watch TV.
That was great.
I had to watch it.
It was great. Yeah.
Yeah.
She said, compelling. I'm dizzy.
Yeah.
I'm
and
sure.
Then she walked off screen. This is like, only like her fifth day at work.
Right. And she's puking. She's throwing up.
Yeah, she's welcome to Sunrise.
Yes. Glad to have you here.
Actually, been here 10 years now. Every reporter is like, CeCe's done it. Like every single morning reporter, when we go out live, it's like kind of their traditional thing they do with reporters.
I want to say that I want to do it next year, but I don't want to.
Is what?
Put
throw them up there?
They get tossed by the bouncing team.
I kind of want to.
I've always been in studio. So I never got to experience it.
We should go out next year.
Maybe both of you next year.
Should we go out? Mm-hmm.
And get tossed at the same
get point? Tossed and get sauced.
Yay.
No, I know that's not. That's
here's Alicia doing, she's doing a beer bong?
While jumping up on the trampoline? That's crazy.
As is tradition in the carnival.
I always think of, every time I hear the Winter Carnival, I think of, we make fun about it of it all the time
South
in
Park.
Terms of the South Park episode with the royal wedding. Anybody?
Dipped the arms in the royal pudding. Yes, it's a funny episode.
Tradition.
They kind of tease the royals.
I feel like John should know this reference.
He watches Paw Patrol.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah, that's true. Only kid things.
I watched like some South Park Family Guy like first five seasons, but I don't know. Probably I watch Paw Patrol now.
Yeah.
That's good, too. Marshall is my favorite.
Marshall.
Which one's Marshall?
He's the firefighter dog.
Yeah.
I thought they were all firefighter dogs, or some of them police, firefighter police.
Yeah, so the main guy's the police, the blue dude.
Remy watches Succession. He's on season 2.
Wow, you're the best parent of all
time. It's fine, he's fine. No, he doesn't. He watches Blippi.
Which one's Blippi? Blippi's
the guy.
Blippi's the insane dude.
He's just like, woo! My husband will act like Blippi and just stand up from the dinner table and be like, whoa! And it makes me laugh so hard because it's so weird. Like, if you see Blippi in real life, you're like, that guy's weird. But the kids think it's fun, and they're like glued to it.
If we saw anybody like that acting normal, we'd be like,
like
hit him with an EpiPen, you know?
He's like, no!
Tranquilize that thing.
We don't want to harm Blippi in any way.
No, we don't.
Disclaimer. We have to do random disclaimers.
The thoughts of our Sunrise anchors do not reflect Carol Evan.
Whoa, you got a dart in your neck.
Oh, it's funny. He'd be like, dart starts with D.
Right. I would love to do it. I would just
be a great Blippi.
Just drink 15 Bush Lights and just start letting her rip. It's like, whoa, Johnny's awesome. Let's pay him millions of dollars.
Why not an energy drink?
Yeah, I thought you were going to say 15 energy drinks.
Yeah.
Nah, that doesn't work for me.
So how do you guys know what's the cool kid shows?
Your kids attract to it on their own.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
They tell you?
Well, now that I got a first grader.
You can, like, gear them towards things. But
there's some interesting conversations at first grade.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it's they know way too much.
Wow.
And, yeah, so it just changes. It changes a lot. But, like, now it's always, I just give Zoe the remote.
So you never.
So you just put parental controls on it, and you just, they just do it.
When do kids realize that the TV's not touchscreen? It's so funny. My nieces and nephews, my son does it.
Four.
He's like, this one. And he's like trying to swipe, and there's just fingerprints. And I'm like, ah.
It's trying to zoom.
Oh, my gosh.
But it makes sense because there's so everything's touchscreen, but the TV's not.
They learn naturally. It's creepy. I watch my kid, my 4-year-old, play Mario Kart on a Wii U, and I'm like,
he knows.
He's
the
phenomenal.
Cheat codes.
Mm-hmm. Wow. He's doing like the, he's can do Rainbow Road.
Right.
He's 4.
Can barely do anything else, but he can
but
do
like,
Rainbow
Road.
But he's
like, hitting all the buttons, like shooting people.
Can't read or write yet,
but
he can kill Rainbow Road.
Right, can you count to 9?
No. No, Rainbow Road.
Kid's gonna be a genius.
You're doing a great job. You're doing a great job. I saw a little thing on my Instagram to say to parents occasionally, like, you're doing a good job, Mom. Because sometimes you don't hear it.
Well, you're doing a great job, both of y'all.
Great Nobody's job. Perfect.
Nobody's perfect, that's very true.
Mm-mm. All right, let's talk about the Packers fan. This is such a Wisconsin thing. You're going to love it, Scotty.
We got Scotty ties in here. I might have missed
this. This is a funny story. So Julie and Belle are Scotty's, and they found this in the Chautauqua. They were sent this from a viewer. From Chautauqua. It's north, like 2 hours
in
Scotty.
Where the heck is Chautauqua?
Where the heck is Chautauqua?
That's a phrase.
Like, you go east of us and drive up, and it's like on your way to, like,
is it like real Wisconsin?
Real Wisconsin.
It's
like overalls
a
lake. And 90 does. Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
Yeah. So this is their 911 logs. Last Saturday morning, a man was seen running down the street in a Chicago Bears cap, yelling, "The Packers still suck." When police found the man, he told them he's the Turtle Whisperer.
Turtle Whisperer. I told
like
you,
ego.
You act like Blippi when you drink Tito's.
Yes.
Turtle Whisperer, yay! Yeah.
Well, that guy is just trying his new career out. Yeah. Let him go.
You know what I do like is, so his wife's quote to the police, where this is what happens when he drinks Tito's, his wife is also a Packers fan. Funniest thing, though, in the Chautauqua times.
Did he get in trouble?
I don't know, because, like, why were the police, because he was loud, or the police were Packers fans, and they were like, you can't say that in Wisconsin.
It's probably just being drunk and disorderly in public.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they.
Oh, noise ordinance, our directors.
Oh.
It was 2:30 in the morning.
Oh, so he's just really loud. Okay.
Yeah, but he was drinking Tito's.
And in Wisconsin, they just come, the cops just come, and they just start boozing with you, so.
Is what?
I don't know why I'm nodding. That's not true.
Yes, no, it's not true. It is not true.
The cops came to my grad party in high school, but not to bust it. They came because it's a small town, and they're like, Alicia's graduating, yay!
They saw the sign on the
road. And I had them, like, put my grandma in handcuffs. I'm like, get her out of here!
Did you really do that?
Yeah. No, they didn't really put her in cuffs, though.
Okay, I was going to say.
That would hurt.
She was, like, 80 years old at the time. Maybe 70.
We were talking yesterday about how drunk Wisconsin is. I think it was like the...
Wisconsin's going to hate us.
Yeah.
We're sorry.
Well, we're just telling you the truth.
I happen to love the people of Wisconsin.
Oh, no, they're great people.
I do, too.
They also like to drink. They love their drink. They do. According to all the studies I've seen.
He did look up a ton of studies because he didn't believe us.
Yeah, I didn't.
They are number one in every category.
Yeah, in terms of, like, people that like
just
to drink.
Just ask the Turtle Whisperer from Chautauqua.
I do. The number one thing that I miss, so I would go to my local liquor store...
And they knew your name. They're like, Johnny!
No.
Okay.
So the liquor store at 11 a.m. on Thursday morning would get fresh cheese curds, and they would just set them out on the table.
For free?
No.
No, you had to buy a pack, get a pack.
But yeah, but you could get the freshest cheese curds at the liquor store. Never
squeaky.
Refrigerated.
No,
squeaky.
they don't refrigerate
fresh cheese curds.
You don't refrigerate.
Mm-mm. They're so fresh.
You don't
it's
need
so
to.
Insane.
You haven't had a
so
fresh
salty.
Warm. They're still like warm almost sometimes.
Yeah. Ooh, that sounds weird.
Yeah.
No, you're going to love it.
Like right out of the udder, right into your mouth.
Oh, wow.
Utter
curds. Don't like that.
Utter curds. I like that one. Wisconsin's just like, it's just like old school. I don't know how to explain it.
Fish Good fries. Time. And they have fish fries every Friday.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Year round.
Like
not just during Lent.
Everywhere in Wisconsin? They just
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm. The supper clubs are huge in Wisconsin.
You can
There's
get
a lot of different
blackened or deep fried, mm-hmm. usually.
Yeah.
And it really, so I always think fish fry is like never-ending fish, all you can eat. Mm-hmm. And usually it's just during Lent, I think, here in Minnesota, from what I've experienced.
How often do people actually do that, though? I'll get like my one fish, and I'm good.
Right.
How much fish can you?
Oh.
But there.
Oh. I'm asking the wrong people.
Yeah, especially this one over here.
So what I do, I just did fish fries this weekend. I must have not killed.
You did kill them.
Yeah,
I murdered.
Yeah.
I filleted 20 fish for six guys. So, I mean, I don't know, like 30 pieces of fish.
That's so good.
For how many guys?
Six, eight, seven.
They're not like, the fish though, they're pretty, they're not where they
big. Yeah, because once you fillet them and get all the bones and whatnot
out. Each piece would be like that big.
Well, yeah.
That's a lot of fish.
Yeah, like 40 of those for seven, eight guys.
Yeah, that's a good amount.
Just fry, we would just fry for like 3 hours, just keep eating.
Mm-hmm. Dang, that sounds good.
The heartburn was wicked.
Do the tartar sauce?
I just do hot sauce.
Tartar sauce.
Tartar sauce. Whoopee. Why are we unhinged? Tartar sauce. I gotta have the tartar sauce. Already.
You like tartar sauce? Dill tartar sauce. I don't like the Kraft stuff.
I make it fresh. Yeah, the pickle juice, pickles, mayo, a little mustard.
You're the chef.
I could do a little bit of ranch dressing too with my fish.
On your fish?
Yeah.
That sounds actually very Minnesotan.
If there's no tartar sauce, I can do ranch dressing. Yeah. Or even ketchup.
I will do ketchup. Mm-hmm. I like hot sauce.
Hot sauce.
Hot sauce and fish?
Yeah.
I have never heard of that before.
Just Frank's.
Or Crystal. Crystal hot sauce.
Crystal's solid.
Yeah, yeah.
Cholula. I'm a Cholula gal.
No. That's too much. I love Cholula.
What? Too hot?
No, it's the flavor Mexican.
Profile.
No.
The flavor
profile. I put
profile.
It on everything.
No.
So that's like, Frank's.
So when I make hot sauces at home, like my favorite, like you can make a sriracha hot sauce, like with sriracha honey and butter. Mm. You can do the same deal with Frank's. You cannot do Cholula. You cannot.
I do agree. I feel like Cholula is for like Mexican inspired dishes.
Sorry, I will no longer. Actually, I do that with sriracha. Like that's for me, it's mostly like Asian dishes that I make. Mm-hmm. It just fits
well.
Yeah,
sriracha and anything else is kind of weird. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I do, you know what? With that being said, I do take sriracha and make it fusion as well. Mm. Fusion as in like put it on everything.
Right.
I put it on pizza. Do sriracha on pizza. Mm. Did you know sriracha's back?
It is back, expensive, but back.
Oh, that specific brand?
Yes, because the knockoffs weren't as good.
Did you see like five random knockoffs showed up when they bailed?
They're like, it's our time to shine.
And I tried them all, and I'm like, these suck.
Mine is a little barbecue. Yeah, you can't beat the OG.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right, do the 7 day. I like that. Look at Friday tomorrow, what he wrote on it. Gloomy. It's just like, might as well make our day bad.
But it's Friday.
I've actually had a lot of people complain to me when I say gloomy. Over the past 10 years.
Friday's gloomy means I should be sad. The word gloomy, it's a word for sadness.
What do you want me to say? Suckage meter at 10?
Yeah, that would be great.
That's a lot of words. I don't know if it's going to fit on there.
Why does it say suckage
just
meter 10?
Hyphen sad. Thank you.
So should we not put those words? So people.
And then a small disclaimer at the bottom, take vitamin D today.
Yeah.
Just
an emoji.
UGH, ugh.
That is how the weather's been.
Ugh.
The weather's been really poopy.
Poopy.
Flippy! All right, we're done.
And we'll end there.